While states are busy replacing aging voting machines ahead of 2020, researchers have developed a learning tool to help sniff out the real from the fake, specifically on social media. Bill O'Neill joins us tonight in Greensboro with this story all new at 6 o'clock.
The tool is called the bottom meter. It helps identify someone on your Twitter account, whether or not they're a real person or a web robot known as a bot.
We found a couple of suspected bots in my Twitter. Among them, Bruce Davis's Twitter account. Davis is a longtime local politician, currently running for mayor of High Point.
Twitter is still kind of new to me, and I'm trying to get familiar with it now.
Davis says his campaign team pretty much runs his Twitter account, but doesn't use any bots. Bots are not all bad. They can help people and companies share information efficiently. But some are used to mislead or deceive.
If you use social media as a source of news and information to inform your ideas and your opinions, then you should be at least aware that we're all vulnerable to manipulation.
Professor Phil Menser from Indiana University helped create the bottom meter. He says deceptive bots can impersonate people, giving them the appearance of having more support than they actually have. It can do the same with opinions, making them seem more popular by retweeting them again and again, using bots to share the message.
So there's nothing that I can see with my human eye that makes it look suspicious.
Professor Menser says the bottom meter, like any machine learning tool, makes mistakes. He says in the case of Bruce Davis, his Twitter account is relatively new with little content and not many followers, all indications of a possible bot. Overall, he says, the tool can help Twitter users identify real people from fake ones.
It makes you take another look and make sure that this is who you think they are. In this case, you would do that and you would say, okay, you know, I know who this is, so nothing to worry about.
If you're not on social media, then you're not really reaching the masses. And so it is important, but it is highly concerning to me.
Professor Menser says that bots are really good at targeting people who are likely to support a candidate or an issue, spreading information that may or may not be deceptive. In Greensboro, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.